In this module, we'll get ourselves familiar with the packet capturing. Now, let's understand how ordinary user perceives the internet. So when he types google.com in the browser, google.com opens for him and he starts working. This is what normal user perceives. But if you look into the professional user, what he'll perceive is when he'll open google.com, first thing that will happen is the DNS query and response will be sent and received. After the IP address is found through DNS, TCP three-way handshake will take place. Once the TCP three-way handshake takes place, then the HTTP GET request is sent to the server, followed by the HTTP response. In the HTTP response, you'll have the code for the web page and the browser will translate the code and then google.com will open in your browser. So you see there is a great difference between the understanding of the normal user and that of the professional. So what I'll try to do is we'll try to be into this scenario of professional user. And what packet capturing will allow us to do is it will allow us to see all these minute little things which normal browser does not allow us to do. And this is what we'll be doing throughout the course so that we can actually understand things in much more better way. So I'll minimize the presentation and we'll start with our packet capturing. I'll open up my Kali Linux virtual machine. I hope you have your Kali Linux machine up and running. We had already discussed this on our last practical session. Now there's a software called as Wireshark. What Wireshark allows us to do is it allows us to capture all the packets. I'll show you an example. Let's say I ping google.com. I can see the reply, but this is not a detailed reply. If you want to really see into the minute details, here you can see it is sending ping request followed by ping reply, and you can also see various TCP related information over here. So we are not going to worry about ping. We'll take our example that we had taken in our slide. So I'll open google.com, and before I press enter, I'll start my Wireshark packet capture again and I'll open. Now google.com has loaded and here you can see there are a lot of packets available. So this is what ordinary user will see. This is what professional user will analyze. So let's see what happened. Very first thing, you can see there is a DNS query followed by the DNS response. After DNS took place, there is a TCP three-way handshake. This is SYN, SYNACK and ACK. This is the three-way handshake that took place. After the three-way handshake, there is a GET request to the google.com website and then the web page is loaded. So you see, once you start packet capturing, there is a lot of details that you will be able to see which normally one cannot see. And this is the reason why we'll be using packet capturing throughout our course, because it is not just about typing commands, it is about understanding on what is happening behind the scenes. So I'll give you one more example of packet capture. I'll close my browser and I'll start the monitor interface. Okay, So here you can see there are a lot of Wi-Fi clients available, like Chetan, Harish, Ishan, etc. So this is what we are seeing from outside, but from the inside, from that I mean from the packet level, we do not know what exactly is happening. So let's analyze what happens behind the scenes. I'll start the packet capture again. I'll select the Monzero interface. I think I'll have to restart my Wireshark. And here you can see Monzero interface. I'll start the Monzero interface and I'll stop it. Let's take this example. So here you can see there is a Wi-Fi call AmiSona. Now this is the beacon frame which is related to that particular wireless device. So if we analyze that beacon frame in detail, this is the address of the Wi-Fi from which the beacon frame is coming from, followed by various different things related to, let's say, you have the capabilities information of the wireless device. I'll minimize this. And here you have the SSID parameter. And SSID is basically the public name for the wireless device. Next to the SSID parameter, there are various supported rates, which is 18 Mbps, the channel version, and lots of other information related to the wireless device. If I minimize this, all we can could see over here is the name of the Wi-Fi. But if we go into the packet capture, we could see various information related to the beacon frames, the supported rates, and so many other things. And this is what and why we'll be using packet capturing for. Wireshark is an amazing piece of software with a great number of features available. There is also a command line utility called TCP dump, which can be used for packet capturing. So I hope this basic concept behind packet capturing has been clear for you. And with this, we'll close our module session for today. Thank you very much.